Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me explain why there may be a relocated items folder on your desktop after updating macOS. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So after a macOS update, you may find this folder here on your desktop. It's called Relocated Items. A very common question is, what is it and can I delete it? And the short answer is, yes, you can delete it. First thing I want you to notice is that this isn't a folder on your desktop. This is an alias. Notice the little arrow here at the bottom left hand corner of the folder telling you that the folder really isn't located there. It's somewhere else. If we were to control click on it and show original, we would see that it's actually located in your shared folder. So your user share folder. So if you were to delete this alias, the relocated items folder doesn't go anywhere. So if you're afraid of deleting something that you may need, you're not actually deleting it by getting it off your desktop. So the quick and easy thing to do is just remove it, put it into the trash, and forget about it. Chances are you probably never look in the shared folder, so having these things in there won't bother you. And let me tell you, the files in there are tiny, so they're not going to take up any space on your drive. So what's actually inside here? Well, what you see may vary, but most likely it looks just like what I've got. You've got a folder here, and you have a PDF called What Are Relocated Items. Let's take a look at that PDF. It explains what these are, but it's using a lot of technical jargon. Basically what it says is these are configuration files. These are files that are part of your system that are different than what's being installed during the update. So the old copy is being saved. Now why are they different? So it says here these are either modified or customized by you or another user. Now if you haven't modified any configuration files, chances are you haven't, and there's nobody else using your Mac that would do that, then it wasn't you. And it also says or by another app. Now if you've installed an app that has for some reason modified your system configuration files, it's probably best to have the update replace those. If the app you're using needs to change the configuration again, it should be smart enough to do so. But more likely what this actually means is that a configuration file in an old version of macOS is different than in the new version that you just installed. It wasn't you or an app that changed it. It's simply different now from the old version to the new version. But the system update for some reason isn't smart enough to know that. It just sees that it's different and it thinks, well, maybe you changed it. I probably shouldn't delete this, so I'm going to save a copy of it just in case. So it's just the difference between an old configuration file and a new one included with the update. It isn't anything you did or an app you installed did. It's basically the macOS update being a little persnickety and making sure that there's a copy of this changed file. So what is this file? Well, let's look under configuration here and you could see there's a folder called private, a folder called etc., and then one called group system default. So this isn't something you would normally modify or an app would normally modify. There's just a slight difference between the old group system default and the new one. So the old one has been saved. But you don't need the old one. And notice that the file size is minuscule. In fact, the PDF telling you about this is many times bigger than the actual file that's being saved. So the simple thing to do is just drag this to the trash and forget about it. But if you really want, you can go in the Finder to the computer level, to the hard drive, users, shared, and you could find that folder and maybe any previous ones that you haven't dealt with there, and you can delete them. But they really don't take up any space, so you don't even need to worry about that. Apple has a support document about this online, and it has a really long URL. So it's just much easier to type Apple relocated items into Google. It's the first hit, and then you come to this simple explanation there. But there's really no extra information here that isn't in the PDF. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.